praise to the Lord. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother in Christ, late Dr. Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia, for burial. Let us pray with confidence in God, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. Deliver your servant Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia, O sovereign Lord, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit, by you live and reign one God forever and ever. I have set God always before me, for he is my right hand, therefore I shall not fall.
Wherefore my heart was glad, and my glory rejoiced, my flesh also rejoiced.
You shall not leave my soul in hell, neither shall you suffer your Holy One to see corruption.
You shall show me the path of life, in your presence is the fullness of joy. And at your right hand is pleasure forevermore.
Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord.
And let my perpetual shine upon him.
We shall take the hymn on page 9, item 2, for all the saints who from their labor rest.
It is certain we carry nothing out. The Lord giveth, the Lord taketh. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Look!
Accorded to our father as a retired general, the church will continue from where they stop. Full military honors for the departed general.
But we don't want to...
Please, you may sit.
I was told.
You may sit.
Peace, mark, love.
Your Excellencies, the Governors of Edo and Delta States, all Excellencies here present, all my Lords, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I lean on established protocol to present the biography of our father, the father of Midwest State, the father of Bendel State, Brigadier General Dr. Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia, retired. CON 1932 to 2017. Here goeth a season, whence cometh another. Brigadier General Dr. Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia, retired, CON, was a man with exceptional brilliance, who, by the standards of any generation, rightly qualifies to be described as a comprehensive genius.
We have seats for you guys. We're barricading nobody.
This certainly is not an overstatement, considering the pedigree of the man. At various times in his very distinguished career as soldier, administrator, and a politician, he blazed enviable trails that were far above the records of his peers and contemporaries. Retired Brigadier General Dr. Samuel Ogbemudia manifested excellence in all he set his hands to do in life, as records show, to such an extent that he became a reference point and a benchmark in political administration, executive foresightedness, and competence. His areas of competence were so legion that today the mere mention of the name Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia exudes an aura of the mythical and the legendary, and as some others would say, magical. In life he was large, but now in death, the famed administrator and manager of men and resources has become much larger. Brigadier General Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia's fame up till his demise on Thursday, 9th of March, 2017, did not stem from mediocrity or charlatanism, but rather from hard work, resilience, ingenuity, and a stoic resolve to add value to humanity and bequeath legacies that justify his creation by the Almighty God. Remarkably, therefore, the iconic general, a legendary administrator, brought into the nation's public life a versatility, brilliance, and foresightedness that underscored the time-honored truism that success did not lie in sermons, pontifications, and precepts, or in the miscellany of empty manifestos, but in a practical demonstration of what is to be done and how to do it. Brigadier General Dr. Samuel Ogbemudia was born, like every other mortal, on the 17th of September, 1932, at his family home in Abehe Street, Ogbe Quarters, Benin City, Edo State. There was nothing unusual about the circumstances of his birth, except that, as the Holy Bible says in the book of Jeremiah 1:5, before he was conceived in his mother's womb, the Lord foreknew him and predestinated him, and as it turned out to be, unto greatness. That this mammoth crowd, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, is here gathered today to give Brigadier General Dr. Samuel Ogbemudia, retired, a befitting farewell, thoroughly underscores the greatness in his life. The outpouring of affection, emotions, and goodwill by the high and low since his death about a week ago has been profuse and overwhelming. It must therefore be a source of comfort to the immediate family that he left behind, that the late general, like Julius Caesar, came, saw, and he conquered. He was commissioned a second lieutenant in 1961. Thereafter, he attended the United States Army Special Welfare School at Fort Bragg, South Carolina, in 1962. As part of his military assignments, Brigadier General Ogbemudia served with the United Nations Peacekeeping Force in Congo, now the Democratic Republic of Congo, for 16 months. He was also part of the operation in Tanzania in 1964. Back home again, he was appointed instructor at the Nigerian Military Training College, Zaria. He became chief instructor in 1965 and brigade major of the 1st Infantry Brigade in 1966. In August 1966, he was posted to the military station Benin City as part of the operational military move by the federal government to reorganize the army after the 1966 coup d'etat. A brave soldier of no mean repute, Brigadier General Samuel Ogbemudia led a small band of daring soldiers of the Nigerian army, despite a serious disadvantage, to halt the swift advancement of the Biafran forces beyond the Midwest in the obvious march to the nation's capital in Lagos. Subsequently, he joined the then Lieutenant Colonel Murtala Muhammad's 2nd Division in the operation that liberated the Midwest state from the Biafran military occupation. I thought that deserved a round of applause. On the 20th of September 1967, as a Lieutenant Colonel, Brigadier General Ogbemudia was appointed the temporary military administrator of the liberated areas of the Midwest. 6 weeks later, when the Midwest was completely rid of the Biafran forces, Samuel Ogbemudia was appointed military governor of Midwest precisely on the 13th of November 1967. Before he left office as military governor on July 29, 1975, following the coup that ousted the administration of General Yakubu Gowon, who incidentally is here with us this morning, Brigadier General Ogbemudia had blazed an enviable trail of development which to date remains unequaled. Across all sectors, the Midwestern development, Brigadier General Ogbemudia left indelible footprints. On road construction, the vast network he created redefined the modernity of Benin City to date. He also connected communities across the state, thus enhancing interaction and commerce to boost the state's economy. The Benin City Master Plan, developed by his administration for the total modernization of the state capital, to date remains a reference point despite spirited efforts of successive administrations to fully actualize the master plan. Despite those efforts, the original dream of the visionary is still far from total actualization. In the education sector, Samuel Ogbemudia's administration made significant impact. His legacies in this sector include the building of secondary schools, colleges of agriculture and education, scholarship schemes for students. The high point of this development was the establishment of the Midwest Institute of Technology in 1970, which later metamorphosed into the University of Benin in 1971. Agriculture, health, and industrial sectors were also areas of monumental strides. Between 1967 and 1975, Midwest State had become one of the most agriculturally developed states in the country. Ogbemudia's administration established the Iyanomo Rubber Research Institute, the Uronigbe Rubber Plantation to boost rubber production in the state, Warake Farms, Agbede Cattle Ranch, Ugeli Fish Ponds, amongst others, were also institutions established by him. Dr. Ogbemudia deepened the scope of healthcare provision in Midwest State with the establishment of specialist hospitals in Benin City, general hospitals in major towns, and health centers in the rural communities. The Bengal Pharmaceutical Company was also established to provide basic drugs to meet the health needs of the people. By far, the greatest area of achievement was in the area of sports and recreation. General Samuel Ogbemudia, by his ingenuity in developing sports, Midwest became the pool and reservoir for champions who ably represented and won laurels for the nation in international sporting competitions such as the Olympic Games, the Commonwealth Games, All Africa Games, etc. The Midwest was indeed a home of champions in athletics, football, boxing, and other sports. Please, a round of applause for our departed father. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this stadium hosting us all today at his funeral was built by General Samuel Ogbemudia and renovated by successive administrations. Befittingly, the stadium was renamed the Samuel Ogbemudia Stadium. Remarkably, Brigadier General Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia's public service did not end in soldiering. He was also a businessman and a politician. In the Second Republic politics, he won the governorship election of Bendel State on the ticket of the National Party of Nigeria, NPN, now defunct. Unfortunately, his tenure was short-lived as he served as civilian governor for just 3 months between 1st of October 1983 to the 31st of December 1983, when the Second Republic was overthrown by the military, which brought into office the then General Muhammadu Buhari, now President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, in a civilian dispensation. General Ogbemudia was invited into public life again in 1994 by General Sani Abacha, who appointed him Minister of Labor and Productivity in his cabinet. He had also served as Chairman, National Sports Commission, Sole Administrator, Nigerian Railways Corporation, Chairman, Petroleum Products Marketing Company. Brigadier General Dr. Samuel Osaigbovo Ogbemudia joined the People's Democratic Party, PDP, in the Fourth Republic politics and was a respected national leader in the party. Notably, he served as Pro-Chancellor and Chairman of Governing Council, University of Abuja. In fact, Brigadier General Ogbemudia died on active service, as he was until his demise last week, the serving Pro-Chancellor of the University of Abuja, Nigeria. Please a round of applause. Even in old age, he was still gracious and active, providing wise counsel to all who cared to seek his counsel. He remained a dignified personality who inspired hope and courage. He symbolized resilience, hard work, firm commitment to the causes he believed in. He remained dear to his immediate community and the nation at large. He was a man of the people. Now he belongs to all ages. In his lifetime, he won so many laurels, awards, and honors that space will not permit us to list here. He was a devoted family man. He is survived by 2 wives and many children. A dear, worthy soldier, administrator, iconic, phenomenal, and noble citizen, may your gentle soul find rest in God's bosom. Amen. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, may I now respectfully invite to take Psalm 90 on page 10, which will be read in alternate verses, Reverend Father Patrick Osagie, standing in for the Archbishop of the Catholic Archdiocese of Benin, Bishop Augustine Akubeze. Reverend Father Osagie, please.